Hello everyone! Welcome to Activity 13. Today we are going to perform the erythrocyte sedimentation rate. The following materials will be needed for the procedure. First, we have the rack. Next, our patient's blood sample, preferably a blood sample that is anticoagulated with 3.8% sodium citrate. And lastly, we have the Westergren tube. Now let's take a look at how this procedure is performed inside the laboratory. But before performing this procedure, it is expected that a venipuncture has been done to collect the sample of the patient, placing the sample inside a vacutainer tube with sodium citrate. Next, remove the cap of the vacutainer tube, and then place the Westergren tube into the vacutainer tube and wait until the blood reaches the zero mark. Make sure that air bubbles are not present inside the Westergren tube. Place the tube vertically into a rack and stand for 1 hour. Make sure that you have a timer beside your rack. Also, make sure that the area where you place your rack inside the laboratory is not prone to any disturbances or vibrations, as this may affect the result of the ESR. After 1 hour, you have to record the number of millimeters the RBCs have fallen and report as millimeters per hour. Don't forget to interpret your ESR result by comparing it to the reference value or normal values as indicated in your hematology reference book. So that's it for your erythrocyte sedimentation rate. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.